If you are wondering how to make your English cocker ready to go to the dog show, this is the video to watch. In this video, we will groom according to the groom standard. We will show you exactly which tools to use, which tools not to use because they damage the coat, and how to groom from A to Z. Hello, this is Kitty for Transgroom TV, and welcome back at this episode of me grooming Miro, the English Cocker Spaniel. Miro is a fantastic temperament. Today we are going to do show grooming. It means we can show Miro in the next week or in the next few days. We are going to groom Miro according to the breed standard. We are going to hand strip and use all tools to protect every single hair. The English Cocker is a water dog, and water dogs have a lot of talc. They produce a kind of a grease to protect them from the water. Now, I think by doing the clipping work and doing much work before the bath, I have a much better result after the bath. So here in this video, you will see me grooming a lot and stripping a lot and clipping a lot, and all I can do before the bath, I will do. If you're wondering about the products being used in this video, please surf to transgroom.com and you will find a blog there where you can find more information about the products being used. Let's do some nail clipping. Here I'm using the large nail clipper, and we are just going to take a little bit off because it's not very long. Miro is a dog who walks a lot, so automatically he grinds off his nails very naturally. To go a little bit shorter, I like to use the nail grinder very much. It's very easy, it goes quickly, and the nails you can very much round off. So when the dog jumps on you, it doesn't really hurt. An easy way to use the nail grinder is like to put your thumb on the paw, like you can use your thumb as a rest and also like a pivot. And then nicely you can turn around the nail grinder around the nails. Let's do some hair clipping. An English Cocker, we don't really use the clippers. Or in other words, you can use the clippers, but actually we clip the flat side or scissor the flat side. We don't really go in. We don't want to have lots of space between the pads because sometimes dogs open their paws and it's not like then a cat foot anymore. When you keep the hair in between, it's more closed. So that's why we don't clip between the pads from American or English Cockers or Spaniels in average. I like doing the paws before the dogs go in the bath because then it's easier after the bath. All the dirty hair is gone. But if you have very dirty dogs, you can also do it after the bath. We don't really want to have sand between the scissors because this is going to damage the scissors. Let's do some ear cleaning. Miro's ears are not so very dirty. Today I'm going to use the liquid ear cleaner, the ear wipes, and the big Q-tips. First I'm going to clean with the liquid, and I'm going to fill the whole ear up, hold it upwards, and then give it a good massage. Not too hard, just slowly, no pushing, and let the liquid solve all the wax and the dirt. Give it another massage on two sides, and then take the big Q-tips. Here you don't have to be afraid of going very deep, because the ear of a dog, it goes down and up again, so you don't have to be afraid of hurting the dogs. Here you can see how dirty the Q-tip is. If it's more dirty, you can even take a new Q-tip, make it a bit wet with the liquid, and clean out the rest. And then to finish, a wipe takes out everything else which is left in there. The English Cocker has like overgrowing undercoat. Here on this part, you can see all the small hairs and the soft, woolly undercoat growing out of the normal thick, glossy coat. Today, I'm going to use the extra large Showtech stripping knife, and I'm also going to try the Showtech shed stopper, and let's see which tool has the best results. For the Showtech extra large, it's very easy. It's like you can use it like a comb, and you just need to put the stripping knife on the coat on like 45 degrees and just comb without pushing too much, so you don't push the teeth of the combs too much on the skin. And then when you take the hairs out of the stripping knife, if you sprinkle those hairs on a white piece of paper, you will see if there's any hairs broken. Whatever stripping knife you use, please test yourself. And there you will see exactly how many hairs are broken or are not broken. You should be able to take out all the hairs with root and everything. And if you check that on that white piece of paper, you will see at the end of the hair, there will be a little ball, and that's the root of the hair. Let me show you the shed stopper. As you can see at this picture, the shed stopper has two angles. The best shed stopper is the angle where the angle is not like that, but goes in a bit. So when you use it, you can use it by holding your elbow normal, and the shed stopper automatically is at 45 degrees. If you have a shed stopper with 90 degrees, it means by using it, if you want to put it on the coat in 45 degrees, you have to lift your elbow. And here you see me using the shed stopper with the wrong angle, and as you can see, you have to like lift your elbow, lift your hand, and it's really not comfortable. This is the correct one. And as you can see, the angle is already good, so you don't have to lift your elbow to use it. And here, let's do some more testing. I'm sprinkling the hair on the paper, and on the paper, you see no broken coats. Many of us know the speed stripper. And there's many questions, can you use the speed stripper on show dogs? No. And here is why. As you can see, I'm sprinkling the hair on the white piece of paper, and you can see many broken coats. This is because the speed stripper is good, but they're knives. And the knives are very sharp. They are meant for commercial use and to take much undercoat off, but it doesn't strip it out, it clips it out. The speed stripper is perfect for all dogs who are neutered or sterilized, and for dogs with very bad coats, which is not possible to be hand stripped. It will help you, but not for show dogs. There's many ways to get out as much of this wool as possible. You can also even use a comb. The only thing you need to do is take some rubber bands and wrap them around the pins of the comb. This is actually very old school, but it's not because it's old school it doesn't work. And if it doesn't work the one way, you can find another way, as long as you get as much wool out as possible, you'll have a very good result. Let's go to the next step. We are going to start the stripping now. You see some products which I'm going to use. I have the stripping powder. I'm going to use that and explain to you why I use it. The finger condoms. I have a very good stripping stone, a very fine stripping knife which won't damage the coat. I will show you this as well. I have a cone and I have a slicker brush. And the slicker brush, I have two sides, one to go up and one to go down. They have different angles. So let's do some stripping. As you can see here, I'm using finger condoms. I'm lifting up the coat with my left hand and only pulling out the points. So this is going to take the most time of the whole dog. I'm actually always going to lift up the coat. And the advantage of lifting up the coat is if you lift up the coat and you only take the points, you will never have spots where it's too short or where it's getting bald. And you will have a very natural finish. For this system, we start at the back and we go forward. It's very easy to strip with the finger condoms because the finger condoms are in latex, and because of the latex you have a lot of grip. And if you don't have enough grip, you can use the powder, and the powder is going to give you double grip. So here you see me combing against the hair to see how many hairs are still sticking out, how thick they are, and then I can also use the Shotek Groom Stone. With the stone, it's also very easy. You just hold it as a comb. It's very small, it goes in your hand. You can just hold it and let the hair slide between your thumb, and you just close your thumb on the stone, and then the hair in between will be pulled out. And in difficult places where it's difficult to lift, you can just do two sides, lift and pluck, and lift and pluck, and lift and pluck. You see in slow motion what's happening. I'm lifting with my left hand. There's a little bit of hairs coming out, and you see me grabbing the points. And then the second system, I'm lifting with my right hand and pulling the points. And here you see in slow motion how much I'm pulling out, lifting, and the points. It's important you don't take a lot out at the time, and it's also very important you take your left hand and you hold it so the skin doesn't come with you, so it's not uncomfortable for the dog. And you can also use your thumb, actually, whatever, as long as the hair comes out. The shoulder needs to be quite short. And because it's quite difficult at the neck, here you see me using the stripping powder. And this will give me more grip, and it's going to be easier to get out the hairs. We strip from the ears to the shoulders, and in front of that line, we won't hand strip, we will clip it. You can scissor it as well, but today I will clip it. It's very important at the side of the tail that it's short, and then you see the leg and you see how long the dog is, and when he waggles his tail you see the tail and the leg and the bum, and you don't see like a big fluffy place where there's a lot of hair. It's not a very comfortable place to strip, but it's very important just next to the tail and under the tail that you hand strip everything. Here you see me using the Groom Stone. As I said, we're going to try different materials, and as the grip wasn't so good, I have now changed to Grippy Fingers. These are the orange finger condoms. Here you see me stripping the head also with the Grippy Fingers, and I'm lifting the coat up, and then the points which are lifted, I'm taking them down. You see it very nicely here in slow motion. With my left hand, I'm holding the skin straight so it's comfortable for the dog. Lifting the hair up and pulling down. And then repeat, repeat, repeat. I'm using my thumb like tweezers, and I'm taking out the hair with the Groom Stone. And here you see me doing this. It means that here I have to go from the eyes to the ears, very short, and all the hair needs to go out above that line, and here it needs to be fine, so not too thick. Every hair who is sticking out needs to go, and we're not doing any clipping work before this is all done, because we don't want to clip hair which needs to be stripped. So that's why it's better to do all the stripping work before you start clipping the ears. Let's do some clipping. So here you see me using the Heiniger Sapphire clipper with blade number 15. And I'm just going to do the inside of the ears. And then I'm like using my finger and going on my finger with the sapphire. And I'm doing this with my finger, like under the ear, not to damage the ear. With my clipper, I'm also always going outside. I'm never going to go in and then back in with my clipper. No, I'm always towards the outside of the ear. The English Cocker ears needs to be very natural. It means not like an American cocker where you can go very short at the ears. It needs to be either scissored or maybe with a 4F you can do it as well. And here with Miro, you will see one side. I will show you how to do it with the clipper with the 4F, and the other side will be scissored. If you do it with the 4F, you can go against the direction and it will still be a very natural finish. Now the other side, I'm using the blenders and a slicker brush to brush up the coat. If you use the blenders, don't forget you go against direction or with direction, but don't go crosswise or horizontal. Many English cockers have like a little skin flap or skin growth, and you have to be very careful. And now you see me scissoring the sides of the head, and I'm going against direction. Here you see how I'm blending the head. So each time I blend, I like pull my scissor backward, just like in stripping. And you see then the hairs which are sticking out. And that's where I will scissor the next time and lift it up again with my scissors. And this will gain you a natural finish. If you have a few days in front of the dog shows where you can do the ears, the Heiniger Mini trimmer is perfect. The little teeth from the Heiniger Mini trimmer are so close to each other, we can go and do the side of the ears, and this will be a bit short. That's why we need to do it a few days before the show, but it's a perfect little clipper to make these perfect sides. Maybe you see the skin coming out too much, but after a few days it'll be fine. So that's why if you use the mini trimmer, it's better to go a few days before the show. And here you see me using the 7F, and I'm going against the direction of the coat, and I'm not going towards the neck. I'm staying like in the line from the ear to the shoulder, and then the rest we will just blend and scissor. Now Miro is nearly ready for the bath, and here you see all the coat which has come off Miro, and we did have a few minutes time to create another English cocker with that coat. So here you see it going away. Let's do some washing. Today we're going to use Fraser Essential because the best is good enough for show dogs. We're going to use the Squeaky Clean shampoo, the Nurturing shampoo, and then the Shine Bright conditioner. The Fraser shampoos are concentrated 30-to-1. It means we are going to pour 30 parts of water into the bottle until the line, and then fill shampoo until the second line, exactly as it says. I like to wet the dogs before we use the shampoo. I always do that, putting the shampoo on, starting to rub a bit, maybe using some water when it's becoming too dry. That was the first wash, and now putting shampoo on again. For the second wash, the first and the second wash will be with the Squeaky Clean shampoo. The third wash we are using the Nurturing shampoo. The Nurturing shampoo simply has more oils, more conditioner already inside the shampoo, and this is better for the skin if you wash the third time or the second time with this shampoo to condition the coat, to give more oils to the coat. And then now we are rinsing, and now you see us using the conditioner. We are using the Shine Bright conditioner. This is a very good conditioner for all the coats that need to have squeaky coat, not so much oils in them to put the coat down, but also not where it's all fluffy to give more volume. So the Shine Bright conditioner from Fraser Essentials is perfect for Miro. And here you see us using the magic towel. The magic towel is a very good tool to use to take a lot of water out of the coat very fast. Here you see the Magic Touch spray. We are going to spray that on the back of Miro because there the coat cannot jump up anymore. Now the coat needs to be straight. So the system is spraying the magic touch number one on the back of the dog, combing everything out or brushing everything out, and using a very warm, rinsed magic towel and put it on the dog, and then putting the dry dude on top of Miro. With the warmth and the product, the magic touch number one, this is going to make that everything will be very straight. You can leave the dry coat and the magic towel like for a few minutes, and then you can even start drying while the dry coat is still on, or you can take out the dry coat. Here you see us using the Zeppelin dryer with the wide attachment. It's important to dry in the direction of the coat, so you don't go against the direction, to make everything as flat as possible. And between the toes, it's also very important it's dry. Between the toes, you can dry the hair upwards. So afterwards, we can do the scissoring and we have a perfect cat foot. Now we've dried most of the hair, the long hair at the tummy and at the side of the dogs. And now we are taking the dryer and going really in to lift up where the root is, to have some lift there. It will make sure that at the tummy we'll have some volume and the long hair is gonna come over it, over the volume, and it's gonna be a nice round, flat coat without having hair sticking out too much. Let's do some brushing. Here you see me putting the pipe with the directional nozzle on the Zeppelin, and now we have a stand dryer. Here we are using the new Russian slicker brush. This brush has extra long pins, and therefore it's fantastic to use on all very long coats, and it has a very good angulation. The pins are very smooth and flexible. They won't hurt the coat and they go deep into the coat, and therefore you can pull the coat with the warm air, all the curls will disappear. You see us using the vet wrap and we are going to comb the ears. This is going to make sure the hair on the ears stay nice and flat. When we are going to take off the vet wrap, it's going to be very straight. So first make sure the hair of the ears are very dried. Just twist around the ears and the vet wrap sticks to each other. This is going to make sure the ears are flat and stay flat, or the hair on the ears. You can leave the vet wrap on even for a few days. Just make sure the ears stay dry. Normally, we take the vet wrap out just before the show. When you are a groomer and you have groomed an English Cocker for a customer and it needs to be perfect, you can also use the vet wrap, and then you can take it off just before the customer arrives. Let's do some scissoring, styling and finishing touches. Here we see us using the mini clipper from Heiniger, because it just simply had a little bit too much hair and everything needs to be perfect. Here I'm using the clipper. I'm not going between the pads but nicely on the pads, because I like it when the dog is running in front of you and he's like lifting his paw. You see all four pads and they're nice and squeaky clean. In the front of the legs, we're doing the finishing. And we're using the blending scissors. I'm going just with the scissors upwards and making the feet in a nice cat foot. Here you see me using the scissoring comb and again the blending scissors. Nice round. Here at the shoulders you see me lifting up some hairs because they were simply sticking out too much, and I am scissoring them off. You can do that, but you can't take this advantage and do that all the time. It's better stripping, but But if you are after the bath and hairs are sticking out on the shoulder, it's okay to scissor the hairs off. If you know you are going to hand strip next time, don't worry about clipping some hair off. Also here at the back, under the tail, it's nice and clean, and I'm scissoring off all the hairs which are too much sticking out. And now I'm at the back legs, and I'm using an extra curved Utsumi scissor. And I don't lift the paws very much, but here you see me lifting the back legs up, and inside the back legs I'm going quite short as well. Here you see me at the back of the pads, it's like a 45 degree angle, and everything behind the pads needs to be really, really short. You don't have to be afraid of going short. Here you see me lifting up the hairs and cutting on top of the scissors. Whatever system is good for you, as long as it's neat and hairs are not sticking out very much anymore. And you see the back of the pads, and there I'm going really short. And on the hook I'm leaving a bit longer. Here you can see a drawing of the line I'm trying to make in the back legs and the tummy, which you can follow. And here I'm lifting up the front legs and doing the tummy. And I don't know if you noticed, but his hair is squeaky clean and very shiny. And here I'm lifting up the back leg and also scissoring towards the tummy. Here you see the back of the hock is short, and you see the angle I'm using. I'm showing you with my comb. It's not straight, but it's like in 45 degrees. And here you see me scissoring the tummy again. And now let's put out the vet wrap, and you will see how straight the hair is. And now let's do some scissoring on the ears, just a bit to make everything nice and straight. Here you see a finished Miro. Miro looks flat, looks shiny, looks happy. Below his left eye, Miro has a scar. This is not from us, this is because Miro was in a dogfight. But otherwise, you see Miro, his coat is very nice, it's very shiny. Miro's grooming is like confirmation grooming. Miro is ready to go to a dog show. This was Kitty for Transgrim TV. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to write them down below and we will answer them. If you need any information about products, please surf to www.transgrim.com, and see you next time in the next episode.